Now, the most accurate weather forecast in South Texas with meteorologist Juan Acuna.
Welcome back, everyone. A very good Thursday afternoon to you. Gorgeous. Finally, a gorgeous day in the coastal bend. We're taking a live look at our One Shoreline camera. Just fantastic. A couple of high clouds out and about. And let's look at the sunset as we go on over to our SPID. Looking absolutely fantastic. We have those high cirrus clouds in place. Should get some more beautiful colors there. If you notice, it was still warm out there this afternoon, despite that frontal boundary coming through. We topped out at 79 degrees. And again, considering that the front came in early this morning, we're still holding on to 76. In fact, we have 70s all over the region, with the exception of Rockport down into Port Aransas as well. They're into the upper 60s. Our water temperature actually warmed into the upper 60s too. The winds are no longer pretty strong. Remember, they were strong yesterday, even early this morning. Still had a wind gust around 41 miles an hour. Those are still light and variable across the region. Everyone below 10 miles an hour at this point. However, what did happen with the front is much drier air. You can no longer feel all that humidity and all that mugginess that's outdoors, as the dew points have fallen into the 30s and 40s, still holding on to the 50s and near the coastline. But these are some big time numbers that are in the negative there. So that just means picture a sponge and just wring it out. That's essentially what happened to the atmosphere last night, as we have really, really dry air that's been replaced into the region. So as we look at the evening forecast, temperatures eventually falling into the upper 50s tonight. Should be spectacular if you have any evening plans, with those northeasterly winds only going to about 4 to 8 miles an hour. Now, offshore, you can see that's where we have all the cloud coverage. That's where all the rainfall is located as well. And we're just left with mainly clear skies at this point. In fact, we have clear skies up to the north of us. Now, everyone's wondering, Juan, where is the cooler temperatures at? Well, that's up in the panhandle for now. And in fact, they're still seeing a little bit of some snowfall there. And Amarillo's holding on to 31 degrees. But look at all the showers and storms out ahead of this. This is a big storm system that is into the central plains. And we have warm air that's riding up all out ahead of that. So that's why we have all these showers and storms. And of course, wrapping behind this is all the cold air. So that's where you find all the snowfall. So that's why we get the big counterclockwise spin with these big upper level storm system. But it's going to take a little bit of time for this frontal boundary to make its way down. So we have to wait until the weekend for that to happen. That's because this upper level storm system is exiting off to the northeast, and it's going to wait for this little disturbance to make its way down to the south. Notice that's where the temperatures are into the teens and 20s as well. Again, as I mentioned, Amarillo is at 31, 52 in Dallas, Fort Worth. So let's track that cold air. Let's see when it's going to come on down. It's still going to be mild for tomorrow. I think we'll top out into the lower 70s, but notice up to the north, if you're going to be traveling there, the temperatures there are holding on to the 20s. Then early Saturday morning and gone into Saturday afternoon, look at that. Temperatures are holding on to the 50s. Temperatures are going to be dropping there. And then as we go into Saturday, Sunday, and even on into Monday as well, we pretty much stay into the 50s. Even Monday afternoon, high pressure moves off to the east, and we'll see a little bit of return flow, and I think we'll get back into the 60s, but another surge of cold air will come down as we go into early Tuesday morning. So here's as I see it. As we go into tomorrow, dry day, cooler, those highs still into the lower 70s. And then as we go into Saturday, it's going to be cloudy. It's going to be drizzle. It's going to be chilly out there. It's going to be pretty damp. That's going to be the same as we go on into Sunday as well. Not looking at a whole lot of rainfall, but maybe a tenth or 0.2 of an inch is going to be possible. NEC Co-op Energy 7-day forecast, 71 tomorrow, 56 on Saturday, 51 on Sunday as well. New Year's Eve looks like a couple of hints of sun, 62 there, but 59 on New Year's Day, with a little bit more sunshine peeking through on Wednesday and on into Thursday.